Beta blockers are a class of medication prescribed for a few different reasons, mainly heart conditions and anxiety. But how does a drug that treats heart failure also help with anxiety? Well, when it comes down to it, the symptoms of heart failure and the physical anxiety response aren't so different. The beta in beta blockers refers to beta-adrenergic receptors, part of the sympathetic nervous system that controls the fight-or-flight response. When activated, it prepares your body for action. Your heart thumps and your pits get all sweaty and your pupils dilate. You probably know this feeling as the adrenaline rush. But sometimes the sympathetic nervous system becomes overactive or erratic, leading to high blood pressure, tremors, or abnormal heart rhythms. The sympathetic nervous system also acts up when you're anxious, which is why you might get that same heart-pumping, sweaty pits feeling. And during a panic attack, the sympathetic nervous system basically maxes out. It's not uncommon to get heart palpitations and shortness of breath. The responses are so similar that when people have a panic attack for the first time, a lot of those people think that they're having a heart attack. There's a whole mechanism that triggers the sympathetic nervous system. Adrenaline and a similar molecule called norepinephrine are chemical messengers that beta-adrenergic receptors are set to pick up. The receptors are large proteins that straddle the membranes of cells that need to detect this signal and respond accordingly, like heart and skeletal muscle. The receptor's ability to change shape allows them to transmit messages from a few molecules outside the cell and cause major changes inside. When adrenaline or norepinephrine comes along and binds to a beta receptor, the receptor shifts and twists to accommodate it. This shift bumps off a smaller protein that was tucked up against the inside edge of the receptor. Now free, this smaller protein activates enzymes, kickstarting a chemical chain reaction of events that spreads throughout the cell, eventually leading to that adrenaline rush feeling. Beta blockers work by blocking this system. The drugs have similar structures to adrenaline and norepinephrine, so they can slot inside the same space on the receptors. But the beta blockers don't fit snugly enough to cause the shift in the receptor that triggers the reaction. So they just sit there for a few hours or so before gradually dissipating away. And in the meantime, signals from adrenaline and norepinephrine won't get transmitted as effectively. By slowing the sympathetic nervous system, beta blockers can help manage heart conditions like high blood pressure and irregular heartbeat, but they can also treat the physical symptoms of anxiety. They don't treat the underlying causes of anxiety, but they can physically calm down your body. And this is also why some people use beta blockers as performance enhancers, like if they want to display more confidence during a speech or cool their nerves before an interview. Beta blockers come along with risks and side effects, though. They can disrupt sleep and cause nausea, abdominal pain, or shortness of breath. They're particularly dangerous for people with asthma or certain heart issues. Plus, they can interfere with other drugs, and coming off of them too suddenly is risky. But when used properly, they can both maintain heart health and help alleviate the symptoms of anxiety by soothing the sympathetic nervous system. Thanks for asking, and thanks especially to all of our patrons on Patreon who keep these answers and all of SciShow running. If you would like to submit questions to be answered or get some videos a few days early, you can go to patreon.com/scishow, and don't forget to go to youtube.com/scishow. And subscribe. Look alive! Today, we're going to talk about the science behind those dark circles under your eyes and all the things that might cause them, tiredness included. There's a simple reason those eye bags look all...